Okay, guys, I am so excited to bring this news to you, but you might have seen on Twitter, Gotham has officially released the very first teaser featuring Jeremiah Valeska, aka the Joker, for the Gotham season finale. And I have to say, I am so surprised that they've released this soon, you know, that we're actually getting our first glimpse at this. And I am slightly dubious, because they made such a fuss about Jeremiah in season 5, and he was in it very little. So I'm a bit dubious of the fact that he's got the first character poster released for season 5's finale, and the fact that we've got the first sort of teaser for the finale, including him, of all characters. But what the hey, let's just soak up all the amazing fun that is gonna come with this. And I mean it, I am so excited. And no, this isn't an April Fool's joke. It is well after 12 o'clock where I currently am right now. So, major spoiler alert now, we're gonna have pictures coming up. And, okay, so right off the get-go, we see that Wayne Tower is much more developed than we've ever remembered it looking. It's all looking a lot more modern. And that the Joker is at Arkham Asylum. And he's not got white face and sort of, you know, red lips and everything on a normal day. And I kind of appreciate that they've shown us that he does have sort of a normal sort of appearance. Well, about as normal as you can call this. He's obviously very damaged, very scarred, and it all looks very scary. He's a very frightening looking character. But it only gets worse once we see him in his full Joker getup. And he's talking about how he can feel something more within him, you know. And I think this is just means, you know, he is the Joker now. But what we've got from this sort of performance in this trailer is exactly what I was hoping to see. A sinister, cackling maniac. And it says, you know, Gotham, the first two episodes at the end of the teaser. And then we just see him with a batarang in his hand and see him screaming and cackling and everything. And this is exactly what I wanted. This looks a lot more extreme than Jerome ever was. I think we're in for him being a real scene stealer. And, you know, outside of the fact that he obviously doesn't have hair, this is some perfect Joker right here. I've been kind of batting back and forth thinking, oh man, Jeremiah's Joker look in the early half of season 5 was perfect. Why would they change it? But then there's just this utterly, utterly terrifying looking take on the Joker. I mean, Jesus, heckin' Christ. It's like Nosferatu had a bad hair day. Jesus. And that's something I've always really loved about Gotham, is this sort of throwback to sort of classic sort of 70s horror and everything. You know what? I was actually going to make a video earlier on, because we've got these set photos from Birds of Prey and the Fantabulous Emancipation of One Harley Quinn. And we have seen the Joker on set, and it looks like it's still Jared Leto. And, you know, okay, maybe the guy deserves a second chance, but he's living in this suburban Los Angeles-looking home, throwing Harley's stuff out the window, which we can presume is a breakup. He's wearing the purple shirt and gold chains that we know from Suicide Squad, so it really does go to show that... Remember when this character had dignity? Well, Gotham clearly knows, because, oof, man, look at him. He's terrifying. His face and everything. And I think this poster here definitely confirms the green hair. And I'm noticing that he's wearing a purple trench coat. It's not a purple suit. And I think this is as I expected. I looked at a lot of the photos from the leaks and everything. And it definitely appears that he's wearing a green suit, but with a purple coat over the top of it. But man, okay, this... I almost kind of feel bad for Jeremiah. He's gone so far off the deep end. He's lost those looks of his. He's lost his stylish hair. He's now an absolute and utter abomination. Man, they were not kidding. They were not kidding when they said the Joker in this is the stuff of nightmares. And I guess he's just going to be called Jay. But still, even then, like... That is a Joker, all right. And as for the bald hair and stuff, I can accept that this is the way it looks. I mean, like, there's certainly more hair than I initially thought on first perception. And it definitely appears to be green. So I'm actually very happy with that, to be honest. Now, obviously, when watching this clip, my first initial thought was sort of, okay, is he going to be more like Jerome, or is he going to be like Jeremiah? And we do see him looking and sounding quite serious on a few occasions. But then he just goes all cackling, screaming maniac and everything. And it's exactly as, like, I think this is more than I was even hoping for. That was, That was absolute lunacy. That was absolutely nightmarish. This makes even Jerome look calculating and cold compared to this. Especially when he's just got the batarang in the back of his hand. And I just love how he has a little pause there. Cameron Monaghan has some seriously amazing comedic timing. And really, I'm hoping that, you know, he gets snapped for more horror roles. But, oh man, it's almost unrecognizable that he's even Cameron Monaghan under there anymore. I mean, in a few shots, yeah. But yeah, I think overall, like, seeing it in HD now, seeing high quality images of it, and seeing how it's supposed to look with, as Boba Talk says, the sheen of the screen, I'm thrilled to bits with this Joker so far. Like, this is this has made every concern I had worthwhile in regards to the Joker and Jeremiah and Jerome and the whole twist and everything, and I've been very critical of that in the past. I recently uploaded the video today about, you know, my feelings towards it now, and I do want to reiterate that is not an April Fool's joke. But okay, this has all come very unexpectedly, actually. Like, we've had that first look at the Batsuit from behind. We've got this teaser for the Joker, this poster for him and everything. Like, I didn't see it coming this soon, but they're doing plenty clearly to sort of whet our appetites. And I am still dubious as to how big of a role he's going to get in the finale. I wouldn't blame them if they did focus it primarily on Penguin and Riddler, as those are the villains we've set up from the very start. But I do hope that Jeremiah, whatever we're going to call him now, is going to get a nice, sufficient role in the finale. Because, to be honest, I was disappointed by how little screen time he's had in season 5 up until Ace Chemicals and everything, and I thought it was a great episode. I just really wished that they hadn't pushed Jeremiah as a season regular in promotional material. And I know it still says guest starring, but they really gave us the impression that he was going to be in it a lot more than he was. Because, I mean, it was the first time he was even on a poster to begin with for Gotham, and, like, he wasn't even on one for season 4, so this kind of implied that we were going to see more of him than we did in the end. So I was admittedly really disappointed by that. It does make me wonder how long the episode's going to be, though. From the looks of things, we are going to spend some time seeing Jeremiah's rehabilitation, his sort of initial stage of brain dead, if you understand me. Like, like at the end of Ace Chemicals, Bruce Wayne himself said, zero signs of brain activity within him. And in the beginning of this teaser, we see there's drool coming out of his mouth. He's completely blank in facial expression and everything. And it does make me wonder how much time we are going to get with the Joker. Maybe he'll just be the final fight or something. Maybe he'll go through the villains, sort of one by one and everything. I don't know, I'm still, like, part of me is really holding on to the idea that maybe he's the main villain. I mean, why waste this character, and why waste Cameron Monaghan on just bit parts, if you don't have to? And I must say, like, Cameron Monaghan, he's done such an amazing job portraying the two characters that he has, and he's really bringing it home with a heck of a final performance from the looks of this teaser. I can't wait to see more, frankly. I wonder if we'll get a longer teaser for the finale before then. From the looks of things, we're easily in for the most terrifying Joker we've ever had. Just by performance and appearance alone, I'm getting some Pennywise vibes from him. In fact, I even got a little Cesar Romero vibe when he had the batarang in the back of his hand and started screaming. Man, Cameron Monaghan, like, what a guy. What a trooper for doing, like, as maniacal of a performance as he's done, and I'm so thrilled. I am so utterly thrilled with what I'm seeing right now. If I feel like, you know, there are definite compromises and stuff, and I don't know, maybe they weren't allowed to use the green hair because that stupid deal that says that they can't use the Joker because they're saving him for such amazing projects like the Jared Leto Joker movie or whatever, but just forget about it. They've done such a nice job with sort of diverting expectations. And I think at the end of the day, I think the Joker is one of those things that I think people will remember most about Gotham. It's Cameron Monaghan's portrayal. Like, if you Google Gotham, surely, like, one of the first things that comes up is Cameron Monaghan. Let's find out. Gotham. Yep, he's right there on number 5, image number 5, that's Cameron Monaghan as Jeremiah Valeska. which is crazy considering how little time he's actually had on screen in the series compared to other characters and stuff. I understand that as Jerome Valeska alone, he's had approximately 2 hours of screen time. That was told by the Jerome Valeska YouTube channel that does all the clips and everything. God bless the guy. Article 13 is going to get him bad, but... yeah, I'm absolutely thrilled. I couldn't be happier with this trailer so far. What a great treat for April Fool's Day. Like, guys, Gotham is... it's April Fool's Day, not Christmas. Come on now. So, what do you guys think of that brief little trailer on Twitter? And what do you think of the Joker's final look? Comment below and discuss. And as always, if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more like it, don't forget to click subscribe, hit the like button, and if you've done that already, you truly are the greatest. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and have a great day.